Okay, once again, good afternoon, everyone. I'll introduce myself. My name is Foram Devang Shah. I've done my master's in clinical psychology, and I'm practicing as a psychologist in school as well as at my own clinic. I'm also a yoga therapist, a yoga instructor, especially dealing with kids. Okay, yoga using as a kids therapy, and I'm also an educationist. So today's topic, attention deficit and hyperactivity in children. Here, and causes and treatment. Here we'll be talking about, see, nowadays each and every child, we can see there is hyperactivity and inattention in each and every child. Okay, so here I'm not bringing the topic ADHD, which is attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. Here we'll talk about attention deficit and hyperactivity in children. So let's just see. So we'll observe few symptoms of inattention. So this is, the child often fails to give attention to detail and makes careless mistakes in schoolwork or at some work or some activity. Second, the child often has difficulty sustaining attention in any task as well as play activity. Okay, so any task also and play activity, which obviously all children find is very interesting. So sometimes they lack their attention there also. Then the child often does not follow through instruction. It's not that they are not able to understand the instruction, or there are some limitations or some oppositional behavior they want to disobey or nothing like that. It's just that they don't follow and they are inattentive and they don't finish schoolwork. Their homework is not completed. Then the child often difficult organizing task, okay, an activity. They have a tough time organizing their things. Second is they avoid and dislike some activity which needs mental attention. Okay, some mental efforts are needed, they avoid, especially schoolwork and homework. Their homework never ends, and they take hours for simple chores also, especially for eating or writing. Here we are talking about inattention symptoms, normal, okay. Then they are easily distracted by extraneous factor. They are doing something, unko sirf chance chahiye, okay, their attention is gone. In classroom also, they are in some other world. Okay, this is also one example of inattention. Like generally, children are seen like by teachers, they are observed that they are seeing outside from the window, not paying attention in the class. Then also they are forgetful in daily activities. This is also one of the symptoms. Then they lose stuff. Kuch bhi bhool ke aate hain roz. Then, as I told you, they are disorganized. Their personification is that. One day she makes A and next day she fails the same subject. Okay. So, this drastic change. So, basically if we say it in ADHD symptom attention deficit, if we talk about, it's difficulty paying attention, struggles to concentrate and complete task, forgetful, easily distracted, okay, poor organizational skill to be summarized, and lethargic, sluggish, shy, anxious. So generally, according to American Psychiatric Association, we see if they are attention deficit type for ADHD symptom, any of the six symptoms should be present within 6 months, for 6 months period. So then they are ADHD. But if you see as normal child, all are not ADHD. Some or the other symptom, you can see one symptom is there or two symptoms are there, not all six. So they are on the verge, but they are not ADHD, but they are, we can say they have attention deficit or low attention span. Then if we talk about hyperactivity symptom, so basically they fidget with hand and feet, lot of fidgety. They can't sit at one place. They leave the especially big complaint from the school and the classroom is he is not sitting at one place. He is roaming around. Ghar pe bhi ek jagah nahi baithta. Okay, so this is the big symptom or complaint. Then they run and climb, like they don't bother sometimes. Lagega, girenge, kuch nahi. They just keep on running, climbing here and there. So this is one more, which is inappropriate. Then difficulty playing and engaging in activity, which especially playing also. They don't play it like calmly. They just hyperactive while playing also. And especially while watching TV. Okay, when we diagnose, so we see all the criteria. Aise nahi ke khel raha hai bara, matlab while playing he is very hyper, but while watching TV he sits for 1 hour and sit quietly and watches. So then this symptom is not proper, that he is watching TV for 1 hour without hyperactivity. So you have to see each and every place where he is sitting and not sitting. Then only you can come to conclusion, okay, this criteria, this symptom is there. It should be in every, each and every area. Watching TV, playing, eating, whatever, all areas. Then they often talk excessively. Bahut bolte hain. Their energy is high, like they don't stop. So again, if we see difficulty controlling behavior with an increased risk for serious or aggressive behavior, okay, and oppositional behavior. Especially these children, aage jaake, they can become little oppositional tendency, ke jiddi ho jate, nahi karunga. And they also engage in future in antisocial conduct. Okay, then fidgety, excessive restlessness, then they burst out, they can't wait for their turn, so hyperactive. So again, 6 or more symptoms for 6 months. If we see persisted for 6 months, then only you can say, okay, ADHD for hyperactive child. Okay, so this is another type of ADHD, ADHD hyperactivity. Then if we say impulsivity symptom, the child often, basically they answer before you ask them. वो अधीर ही रहते हैं कि नहीं मेरे को ही बोलना है. दे कांट वेट फॉर दैट टर्न. सो हियर बिफोर टीचर आस्क जस्ट पिक मी, ही इज अप ऑन द चेयर ऑन द बेंच. ओके, दे बेसिकली इंट्रूड्स ऑन अदर्स. और कोई कुछ बोल रहा है बीच में इंटरप्ट करेंगे. ओके, सो दे आर वेरी इंपल्सिव. दे विल नॉट थिंक बिफोर एक्टिंग. यहाँ पे आया और दे एक्टेड. Then as I told you, they don't wait for their turns. Agar wo last hain, toh then there is a problem. They want to be first all the time. Okay, so difficulty waiting for his turn. So basically, if we say like all this criteria, we see somewhere down the line in all the kids. Okay, some here, some there. So if we ask, why my child is so hyper? Okay, so first, basically, children are bundle of energy. Okay, as child, they are naturally bundle of energy. So one thing, they are not utilizing their energy. Okay, this is one reason where they can be hyper. Then second is, you have to see whether your child's hyperactivity is normal for their age. Okay, so if child is in preschool, it's obvious ki wo ek jagah pe nahin baithega. It's his tendency, but still you have to differentiate. Preschoolers generally, they are very active. They are very curious. They are so enthusiastic ki har ek cheez ko touch karna hai, try karna hai, because it's their stage of development. So you have to check this. And other teens are generally, they are energetic, okay, and don't have same attention span as adults. So it is common for teenage also. So you have to very carefully see why your child is so hyper. Then some food additives, maybe sugar. See, 100% it's not proved that sugar is causing ADHD or hyperactivity, but still when your child is hyper, you have to make sure on his or her sugar content. Okay, especially some artificial colors, some candies which have some chemicals. Okay, so you have to be aware of that. So fruit drinks, even soda bicarb, all the colored drinks, so you have to see, basically they are drinking all the natural juices and fruits. Okay, then lots of hub in the house make him hyper. Basically, the house where environment is very hyper itself. Like there are conflicts with the parents, okay, or parents themselves conflicting, or there is a lot of, like there are lot of there is noise pollution around and as well as in the house. Ke subah subah sab jagah pe sab chalu hai, TV chalu hai, music chalu hai, ye chalu, wo chalu hai. So this will make your child hyper. So you have to see, not sure ke they can turn into ADHD, but you have to make sure what is making that person hyper. Okay, so this can cause a lot of stress. So, and sometimes child needs attention of mother and father, you know, in a quiet environment. So, you have to check for that also. So, there are some ways, like basically a couch with the blanket, or when you are there with the child, give time to child. This can reduce this symptom. And third is, your hyper child is not getting enough exercise. Especially for children, play is their activity. It's their food. So, with obviously with everything taking care of, we have to focus on the exercise part. Football or cricket or skating. So, basically some physical activity should be there. Some out. Aaj ke, like now, children are so busy with their work. Like, ghar pe aake, either they are playing, but they are playing on mobile. So, some physical activity has to be there every day. So, this is one reason. And one, they have given, like, you can play some sandbox. So, with that also, it will make them calm. Okay, sandbox. So, sand therapy. Then, inattention also, if we talk about, like, it is not always result of ADHD. So, what, like, one reason can be just, they are just tired. Okay, for, if we say, continue 2-3 mahine unka kuch exam chal raha hai, and they are just behind their studies or they are behind some work, so they are tired. Then less lack of sleep, properly they are not getting sleep. Then one more reason can be hyperthyroidism. Okay, this is making children hyperactive. Then learning disability, some who are LD, there are higher chances for them to be hyperactive or ADHD. So, other causes can be like some deficit disorder, depression, anxiety disorder. If children are diagnosed with this disorder, you have to check their hyperactivity level, and they can be ADHD with this disorders. So, if... Okay. So, if I ask you a question like, does your child or student or brother have trouble paying attention? We saw three symptoms. One was inattention, second was hyperactivity, and third was impulsivity. So, these are three questions basically you have to ask yourself. Okay. So, if they have trouble paying attention, second they have trouble staying at one place, they are very fidgety, and third they don't think before they act. So, if answer is yes, there can be some possibility that they are ADHD. What is ADHD? It's attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. Okay, so in this it is combined with attention deficit also and hyperactivity also. But if only they are not hyperactive, then it's only ADD, attention deficit disorder. Okay, so they can be either both or only attention deficit. But there is a like big difference. Hyperactive will be very hyper. And where at the same time, attention deficit disorder, they can be shy, they can be anxious, very calm, but attention deficit, so they are ADHD. Okay, so it is one of the most common neurobehavioral disorder. It's neurobehavioral disorder and usually diagnosed in childhood and often in adulthood, it persists. Okay, so 60% of children who have experienced ADHD in childhood, there are chances it can be seen in adulthood also. So, children with ADHD may switch too quickly from one activity to next. Ek liya, dusra. Dusra liya, what next? They have this question. Matlab, they are sitting for play also or some mobile. Mobile liya, wo choda. Fir TV dekha, wo bhi abhi ghanta lag gaya. What next? What next? What? So, they just want stimulation continuously because they are, as I told you, they have a lot of energy. Easily distracted, they forget things, have trouble finishing tasks, homework. They run around. They touch and they want to touch everything. They want to explore everything. Kahan bhi jayenge aise baithenge nahi. So mother are mostly embarrassed ke mera bachcha baithta nahi hai. He is running around. But these are the hyperactive children. They do it. They are very impatient. Okay. So basically here if we say this, when it becomes a problem, when it becomes ADHD. See, all are hyper. As I told you, some things are common in children. And it is natural for them. But when it affects their academic setting and functioning in day-to-day life, then it becomes a problem. Like every day, he's not doing for some time. We can say he's not slept properly, or some diet problem, or some stomach ache, whatever, some physical problem. But if this symptoms is affecting his or her academic functioning continuously, okay, or some home task continuously, then we can see like there is a problem and it needs attention. So if we talk about ADHD, basically it begins in childhood. So onset is 7 years. So this is very crucial period where you have to see for symptoms, okay, whether your child's hyperactivity is of that age range or it is affecting their academic or social functioning. You have to see that. Okay, so basically they say, like research say, it affects 3-5% of school age children. Okay, so 3-5% are affected. Then boys are more affected than girls. So boys are outnumbering by 3-1, and they have said like in past 8 years, 42% increase is there in ADHD. Okay, here I want to bring like to attention one more thing. For ADHD, when we diagnose ADHD, the scales are of parental scale, parental report. Okay, so हमारे पास parent आते हैं, we give them test, so they write, okay, hyperactive they mark it, oh बहुत ज़्यादा है, inattention बहुत ज़्यादा है, everything. There are criteria, mild, medium and extreme, but they feel कि नहीं, ये सब चीज़ें for them it's too much. Okay, so they tick that and उसके score पे score is higher. There are some criteria ki it's se niche aaya so they are not ADHD and isse upar aaya so they are ADHD. So basically it's parental report. So generally nowadays there are lot of children being diagnosed with ADHD. Okay, so this is one more reason, like 42% increase in last 8 years in ADHD. Okay, then if we see the statistics, see basically when they are 6 year, 7 year, 8 year, 9 year and 10 year, it is growing up. And
is it because of the lifestyle or because of population?
Lifestyle, population, no. Lifestyle, yes. And there are so many factors involved. As I told you, if we take water, food, environment, pollution, parenting, school, media. There are so many things. It's not only one thing. So apart it's everything is genetically. Yes, apart from genetic. And here if we see like hyperactivity is 2.5%, like these are the types, three types as I told you, ADHD, hyperactive are 2.5% if we say overall, then inattentive type are 1.3 and 0.9 is combined. Okay. And it was also seen that it is socioeconomic status, it was seen more in lower socioeconomic background because of, as I told you, these reasons. Okay, so it's ADHD seen more in lower socioeconomic background. So if we talk about causes, what are the causes? See, first they are pointing out on genes and heredity. Okay, second, environmental factors and brain injuries and change in the brain structure. These are the main causes. So hereditary, yes, it is passed from parents to children. See, there are genetic characteristics that seems to be passed down. So there are 50% chances. Agar parents ko hai, to bacche mein aane wala hai ADHD. Then if sibling, one of the sibling has, then there are 30% chance of having ADHD. Then smoking or drinking during pregnancy. This is also leading to ADHD. First is birth complication and very low birth weight. So this is another reason. Then pathophysiology, if we talk about, like dopamine is one of the neurotransmitter which plays important role for ADHD. So they have said that norepinephrine, like basically these are two neurotransmitter, its imbalance cause ADHD in children. Second is their overexpression. It was seen in ADHD, brain studies on individual with ADHD suggests that there is a defect in dopamine receptor, that is D4, and overexpression of dopamine transporter 1. So these are the neurotransmitter which are in brain, like especially in brain. So it usme kuch bhi balance nahi hai, then it over or under dopamine or norepinephrine will lead to ADHD. So it is again neurobiological. See here you can see, in this is the MRI image, here you can see the structural change in the brain which also leads to ADHD. Okay, then toxic exposure, then children with ADHD have high levels of, they have found that lead is there in their blood which is higher in level. So as I told you, low social economic background where especially there is lot of toxic exposure, so it can also one of the reason. Then media and ADHD, as we all know nowadays, and lot of research says that fast paced like TV channels, okay, fast paced flashing all the news, okay, flashing of one behind the other picture, okay, so this is leading to their attention deficit. And second is seeing or playing violent video games, violent scene on the TV, violent movies. So this has affected their hyperactivity, and in turn obviously it has connection to ADHD. We can't say that fully they are related, but yes, there are some contribution of media to ADHD. Then as I told you, this is one hypothesis, is shift hypothesis, that fast paced media, ek ke baad ek flashes are there in front of TV. So in your like child's brain now, it is so fast, it's everything is happening so fast that attention span has reduced, okay. So this brain is not able to take it so fast. So itne se 2 saal ke bacche ko bhi wo itna fast ja raha hai. So now their attention span is lacking because of this. So this is, these are two research. To observe all the signs before before coming to conclusion your child's behavior, like whether he is ADHD or it's just normal hyperactivity, there are 2-3 symptoms, or so you have to evaluate each and every sign and symptom, or you can consult if you find any signs. See, better is if you see any sign and if you consult someone, so better is early diagnosis is a better treatment. Okay, see, if we talk about differences in ADHD versus high activity child, so basically some children they don't like, there are some preferences. Okay, here it says that some who they love to play outside, okay, so they are okay when they play outside, but some indoor tasks they don't like, they are of that preference, they don't like, so that time they become hyperactive. It's not that they are ADHD. Then some are very active, so because of our language, you know, we easily say, oh, ye to hyperactive hai. So we are just labeling without understanding the level. Okay, so you have to be very cautious, like labeling your child with ADHD, like hyperactivity, attention deficit, or ADHD. So as I told you, okay, there is no proven way to prevent ADHD, but early identification and treatment is the best remedy for ADHD and associated disorder. See, they get better with treatment, but there is no permanent cure. But there are 3 basic types of treatment. So one is medication. This is for ADHD child, okay, but if you have some higher level of hyperactivity or inattention, you can also go for medication, but with the supervision of doctor or psychiatrist or psychologist. Okay, so they are called stimulants, medication. Then therapy, if we talk about, then behavioral therapy works well for them. What is behavioral therapy? Generally it includes punishment and rewards, more of rewards, okay, for their appropriate behavior. And medication and combined therapy is also used, and also yoga and meditation and yogic games have, like, from like past 1 year, I'm using this very like effectively, and especially yoga has seen, like, especially with ADHD kids, not hyperactive, but with ADHD kids, it has shown very good results. Yoga, pranayama, meditation, and yogic games, lot of yogic games. Yes.
So that again yoga exercise requires concentration.
Yes, they do it. Like, see, initially one child was coming to me. Initially he was not sitting at one place. He was just in senior KG. So teacher was complaining he's not sitting at one place. So he came for counseling. Okay. So counseling with this small child was next step for me. So first I started with yoga with him. So initially he was not sitting there also in the yoga studio. He was running around. Okay. Then he was spitting on me. When I used to show asana, he was climbing on me. By the time, like after 1 month or 3 months, you can say he started sitting. And then slowly, slowly, now if you can see, he can sit for meditation also. Okay, and he's doing. So with children and when patients also, and when they are seeing other children doing, they do. Okay, so yeah. And you need tech to deal with them. Basically, some yogic games are also very helpful because they think it's a game, but they are actually doing yoga in yogic way. Like, so it has a lot of impact on children.
Some challenging games also will be useful.
Yes, but it should not increase their hyperactivity level, because when they lose, they are badly hyper. Like, they want to be first always, they want to win always. So you have to see their mood and their situation.
Just to dissipate their energy.
Yes, that's there. Yes. So like all the things, basically outdoor games are advisable, like football or some running game or cricket is advisable. So medication is Ritalin. So if we talk about the treatment, so psychiatrists, psychologists, CBT, behavioral coaches, all these things are associated with like parental training, behavioral intervention strategy, medication when necessary. So these are the treatment plan which is all incorporated for ADHD children. This is one of the ABC model. It says antecedent, behavior and consequences. So here if we see 9:30 bell rings, bell signals, beginning of maths period. So behavioral student ignores the bell while rest of the class takes out the maths book. This of a one child. And then consequences is teacher yells at the student. Okay, this is ABC model. And if we make some changes in this, so here what are the contingencies? Contingencies are teacher makes eye contact with the student and says, take out your maths book. Okay. Here, 9:30 bell signals, beginning of the maths period, behavioral student takes out maths book and consequence teacher smiles at the student. So there was a different with few changes here and there, a eye contact, a praise. So we can see the difference. So these are the tips for parent. Basically, they should believe their child, support their child, then keep things in perspective, then pay attention to the sibling also. Take yourself, communicate, connect, okay, be consistent. Your behavior as a parent should be consistent. Aaj ye, kal ye, it should not be like that. That one time, like you should also behave the way you want your child to behave. You are saying ke you don't watch TV, you don't watch violent act, but you are watching for 3 hours sitting in front of TV, it's not a good option. So basically you have to be consistent in your behavior and in your saying. What are you saying, you should also do. Then set a good example, as I told you. As a parent, you are role model for your child. So all of you, like, set a good example. Then praise good behavior. It's very important, as I told you. Praising is very good, important, but praising good behavior. Don't support each and every negative behavior. Then what changes you can make at home? As I told you, when sometime noise is there at the home or in around. So you can make create a peaceful environment for your child, which is one. So they can read and do their homework. Sometimes this is the smaller reason why your child is hyper, but you are not aware. But this is, you can change. Then enough sleep, good diet, then lot of plenty of fibers and nutritionist food. And some regulation on TV and computer activity. Some hours should be fixed, some rules and regulation in the house that all are following it. Not only children, but all are following it. Then managing your child's ADHD at home again. So basically sleep as we talk. Then compliment your child's good behavior and rules, set up rules. Especially for teachers, we advise a lot of things to teachers also. As parent, you can also do the same. See, children, we know the symptoms. So if wo window ke baju mein baithega, they are definitely going to see out. So teacher has to make sure that children is sitting, like the child who is mischievous or who is lacking attention is sitting next in front of her. So one is sitting arrangement, then structure of the class. Okay, there are so much things which are, you know, extraneous factors are taking their attention. Or koi cheez hai jo which is making child more attentive there. So they should take out that thing. So structure is important. Okay, then role models, peer tutoring. As one child who is very hyper, and if, as I told you, other friend is doing so and he is helping that child, it can help in better way. Some creativity is also very good, like creativity in the sense, aise nahi ke ye picture hai, uske andar aap color karo. Okay, they are hyper and they need that energy to expand. Okay, so you just provide color and paper, let them do what they want. Creativity not like bound karke nahi ke you do make isme se yehi banao, sky ko blue hi color karo. So creativity not in that way, creativity in that way which will expand their brain also and which will make them grow. Okay, you just provide things and let them do whatever they want. Agar wo log ghande ho rahe hain, color gira rahe hain, kuch bhi kar rahe hain, let them do. So this is one kind of option. Then maintain eye contact is very important with this kind of a children. Comprehension, positive guidance, and some assignment, like as I told you, as behavioral therapist also we give some assignment. For if you are behaving this way, these are some token or some rewards. So this way teachers can also do. Teachers, if they want, like teachers can make them sit in front of them, then they can repeat the instruction. Okay, something they have to do extra, some extra effort they have to do for this kind of a children. Then something, some great tips, be informed, okay, about things and about your child. Then move towards a project-based classroom, okay, where they are busy. Basically, the energy should be utilized. Then some easy direction should be made for kid to understand. Then you can make some highlighters for your child, so they can use that, jo unke liye easy ho jaye, because they are not organized. Some kids, if you see this, you have to evaluate your treatment plan according to your symptom. If your child is inattentive in somehow, like he is not organizing things or he is forgetting things, so you have to make him do something which he realizes, okay, some highlighter or something which are just popping up, some reminders, so this will help them. And ask for help. Okay, then these are some myths about ADHD children or ADD children. Basically, they say that all kids with ADD are hyperactive, which is not true. As I told you, some are not hyperactive, they are just lacking attention. They are just attention deficit. Then second is they never pay attention, which is also again one kind, but they are some, obviously they pay attention, but they are just hyper. Koi log hyperactive itne, their IQ level is so high, they are not paying attention. They are seeing somewhere else, but unko sab aata hai aur sab yaad rehta hai. They just learn for once and they remember. Okay, so you can't say ki they are not paying attention. They are hyper, so they are not paying attention. They are paying attention, but they are in some other thing also, but they are paying attention. Third is kids with ADHD could behave better if they wanted to. And kids will eventually grow out of ADHD. Medication is the best treatment option for ADHD. So these are the myths.
So it's not in their hands to behave properly or not behave.
Yes, because sometime when it's neurobiological, some neurotransmitters are playing role or some brain structure is playing role, it's not in their hand.
So these tips that we are trying to do, then that is going to give them, support them, improve on their behavior?
Yes, see, parental support, yes, you will support also, and sometime with your help only it can improve also if condition is that not that severe. But if they are really ADHD, then obviously you need some counselor and psychiatrist to help you. But obviously these are the changes you can do at home also, because at home you are playing, like they are going to counselor for 1 hour, 2 hour in one day, but child is home, like at home for full day. So it's parents and teachers' duty is big, that they should follow this. Okay, some children who are ADHD, they need attention. They are doing it for attention. So this also you should keep in mind, okay, what is actually, you should be aware that what they want, what is their need. वो थोड़ा साथ में रह के पता चलता है, ओके दिस, इफ आई विल डू दिस दे विल बिहेव इन दिस वे. ओके, सो ईच एंड एवरी सिम्टम इज डिफरेंट. Nowadays, like as I told you, ADHD is a label. Generally, we put on child, you are ADHD. And children also know, I am ADHD. Sometime, they want to take that privilege. Okay, yeah. I am ADHD. Okay, so labeling should not be there. So this is when I came across this letter. So a student letter to his teacher who is ADHD. It says, I am not crazy, lazy, bad or stupid. In fact, my IQ score is most likely above average, and many people with ADHD are also gifted. Gifted means their IQ is 130 up, okay? But because my brain is wired differently than that of regular student, I sometimes feel stupid or bad. Sometimes it's hard for me to admit that I need help, okay? Sometimes it's easier and less humiliating to act like I understand, or to act angry to distract you from finding out that I am having trouble, and so that the other kids in the class don't know that I am struggling. I need to know that you won't make fun of me and shame me when I ask for help.
He's a mature man.
Yeah. So in conclusion, I wrote this. So we should not stamp one child with ADHD. If we say he's lazy, he's worthless, bad and dumb. So there are some positive traits also in ADHD kids, which are, they are very creative, there is flexibility, they are enthusiastic, their energy and drive is high. So these are some positive traits. Motivated, like they are full of energy. You should just know to utilize their energy. Yes. So never give up on someone with a mental illness. When I is replaced by we, illness become wellness. Thank you.
Thank you.